a lot of guys pulling their bikes off the grid, a lot, that, and they're heading back to change wheels and start from, you know, on the warm-up lap from the pit lane.
Wow. Yeah, Carol Abraham, Andrea Iannone, I can see. Hafiz Shahin's walking off the grid. Danilo Petrucci, I can see as well. He's walking off the grid. The two KTMs are being pushed back as well.
They're all going to do it.
Yep, Scott Redding's walking as well. That's about as far down as I can see. Scott Redding was in 15th place on the grid. I can just about see row 5.
Nakagami.
It's like a mass exodus here.
Hearing a bit of the Argentinian national anthem there, but there's so much going on that we feel compelled to come in. It looks like just about everyone's coming off the grid here, Simon.
Well, I'm standing in the middle of the grid and the last four rows have disappeared. And now there's more moving, like for example, Maverick Vinales is walking past next to his bike. Dovi's coming. Here goes Cal Crutchlow. They're all walking backwards, walking back to the pits with their bikes and mechanics, and I would say there's only Lorenzo sitting still. There goes Valentino as well. He's left. Zarco has just decided to leave. There's nobody left. The only one is Jack sitting on pole, and now I look back, the only one is Jack and Lorenzo.
You know why that is, don't you?
He's on slicks.
Jack's already gambled on slicks earlier on.
I've never ever in my life, 23 years I've been in the MotoGP World Championship, have I ever witnessed anything quite like this. I mean, it's chaos down there. It's absolute carnage. Si Reed just got out on a slick shod Monster Yamaha Tech 3 machine.
Now Lorenzo's gone as well, so Jack's sitting on the grid by himself.
Jack, there he is.
The start has to be delayed. I mean, we're only, 7 minutes away from the off, and we've got basically one rider sat on the grid. Jack Miller might not agree with that, but...
Yeah, well, Jack there gambled on a slick before anyone else, unsurprisingly. Jorge Lorenzo, perhaps he was just waiting to see if there was a couple of spits of rain again.
It's like a Grand National start out of pit lane, isn't it? We've got a whole bunch of riders have come in for their dry setting bike. Simon?
Well, I just overheard some Urta guys yelling, it doesn't make sense, there's only one guy on the grid. So I gather they're going to plan, to do something else, let it all go separate.
Miller doesn't need to come off the grid because he's already on slicks.
No,
exactly. That's why Miller's just going, well, why should I get off the grid? I'm ready. I've got my slick bike ready to go. So he can just sit tight and wait for everybody else to sort themselves out.
You're about to see something that you'll have never seen before. A warm-up lap is going to begin with one bike on the grid and everybody else leaving pit lane. Remarkable. Jack has a look around.
Well, I think Miller's saying, hey, guys, look, I've made my tyre choice. I'm ready to start the race.
It was declared a wet race, let's not forget.
Bradley Smith's been kind enough to talk to us. He's about to, ready to get on his bike.
It's chaos, but I don't know. I don't think some of the guys necessarily understand exactly what's going on. We're just being patient here with the tyre warmers, and then we'll wait and see. But the track's getting drier and drier. It seems the right decision to do slicks, but if it drizzles at any point, then we go to wet. So. It's touch and go, so let's see what the race direction decide. But we're trying to make smart calls here.
Thank you.
It seems a little unfair on Jack, doesn't it? If you're a Jack Miller fan at home at the moment, you're going to be saying to yourself, this is a bit unfair that the start's been delayed. He made his choice, declared a wet race, he went for a slick.
He made his choice, he's ready, his team's ready.
Yeah, guys, everybody, like the whole grid, except for Jack, was waiting in the pit lane, ready to go. Still in their garages, but majority waiting at the pit lane exit, and they've just been told to come back, something else is happening.
race start delayed due to safety conditions, and I can tell you exactly what's going to happen now. It's going to be started as a dry race.
Well,
as you'd expect now, Francesco Guidotti, who's the team manager of the Alma Pramac Ducati team, with Jack Miller in close cahoots to him, they're having a long discussion with a few officials down there, just trying to find out exactly what's going on, because they are still lined up on the grid, ready to go. There's 23 other riders who are now in the pit lane trying to decide whether what they're going to do and await the opening of the pit lane again to try and get this Argentinian Grand Prix started. I never, ever recall a scenario quite like this. And all for the sake of a 45-second bit of drizzle?
Guys, I've got Maverick Vinales here. Maverick, do you think it's the right decision?
Honestly, I don't understand why we cannot go, because, well, we were fast, you know, to the side and be at least with some more front position, but anyway, we have to wait.
Thank you.
Well, reading between the lines there, Maverick was ready to go. Sounds like he'd gone to slicks.
He had, and he was waiting at pit lane exit, fully ready for the race, like a lot of other guys, yeah. And now it's delayed. And I agree with you guys, if I was Francesco Guidotti and especially Jack, I'd be very disappointed because, it's not fair. They made the right call. But, you know, they must be considering safety in some way that they can see a danger from by doing this.
Well, Maverick, pretty adamant. He was ready to go. He made his decision too. He was ready to start the warm-up lap from the pit lane.
The problem is that by starting in pit lane, you start then at the back of the grid. But then what happens in what order? That's the problem. One of the problems they've got as well is that you can't just stick them all on the line. And there's so much confusion. I've never seen this in my life.
Well, of course, we can't have a mass start like we saw from the Saxon Ring a few years ago. I think when there were six riders, it was raining on the warm-up lap in the Saxon Ring, I recall, 2014 maybe. And there was literally about six riders actually started the race on the grid. There is Jack Miller, absolutely all on his lonesome, sitting in pole position, ready to go to start the race. Alex Rins isn't. He's just taking his helmet off, so there's quite a bit of deliberating and discussing going on here. There's Mike Trimby from the International Race Teams Association with the Erta jacket on, the black jacket, who's being stalked, shall we say, by KTM boss Mike Leitner, who has a big puff of the cheeks. Francesco Guidotti is still trying to find out what is going on and why this race is not starting with their man ready to go from pole position. David Obrivio from Suzuki was also down there trying to find out when this 25-lap race will be getting underway. I've never seen anything like this before. One rider, the rider who qualified in pole position as well, just sat on the grid waiting.
If you've just tuned in without any sound, you'd be wondering what on earth's going on at the moment. But to be honest, we're not quite sure ourselves. But only Jack Miller on the grid, on slicks.
Well, there were a bunch of other... I mean, Maverick Vinales was not on his own in queuing up at the end of pit lane, who'd come in and switched to slick tyres. I saw Hafiz Sarr, and he was definitely one of them. There was a big group of riders, probably half the field if you include Jack Miller as well, who were obviously pretty much set to go. Start the warm-up lap from pit lane, form on the grid, crack on.
Had the circuit not have dried quite so quickly, you would have had a situation there, I think, where we would have started a damp race with everyone on wets and Jack Miller on slicks. Unfortunately for Jack, the rapid rate that it has dried because of a rise in temperature, it's too hot.
Yeah, I wasn't surprised that Miller was going to gamble again. His gamble paid off brilliantly yesterday in qualifying when it was it was damp and wet at turns 7 and 8. He knew that in those first two sections, if he got the hammer down, he could make up time, and whatever he was potentially going to lose in turns 7 and 8, he'd gain in those first two sectors. Bradley Smith looking pretty pensive, sat on his KTM RC60. I can now see race director Mike Webb. He's left race control and he's now on his way down to the grid. Well, he's only going to find Jack Miller on it at this stage. Maya Merigali and Davide Tardozzi, Michael Bartolomei and Alberto Puig. Senior management then from all the teams now are obviously being called to a bit of an impromptu summit on the grid here. Lucio Cecinello also on his way down. So, Simon, it looks like there's a meeting of the management about to be called to discuss how we proceed here.
Yeah, I just had a good chat with Brent Stevens and Alex Briggs and said, have you guys ever seen this before? And they went, yeah, Sachsenring. And they said, it's why they don't want to do it again, because, well, the Erta guys said that, Dorna had said they'd never wanted to do it again because there was pretty much a race and an elbow pushing scene at the end of the pit lane, you know, trying to get out first. And then when they all left the pit lane in that group, they said it was chaos, like danger, you know, nobody, there was no order. And so they said, we don't want to do that again. That's why they don't want to do it now.
There you go. Confirmation is what we suspected. Jack Miller out on those slick tyres. Simon, it's going to be brave, but I just wonder if you might want to try and stick a microphone on the Jack Miller's helmet right now, just to find out exactly what he's thinking, because we're not anywhere near close to starting this race. I just wonder what is going through Jack's mind right now, because here we go. Here's that impromptu summit on the grid. You can see Davide Brivio from Suzuki. Davide Tardozzi's there. Francesco Guidotti, Michael Bartolomei, Gino Borsoi from the Angel Nieto team, Maya Merigali, and it's Mike Webb dishing out the instructions now to explain exactly where we move on from here.
If I had to guess what's going to happen, I think Miller will get removed off the grid. They'll all be pushed into pit lane. They'll do another sighting lap, and it'll be a quick start procedure with a dry race.
Oh, I mean, we could not have a repeat of the situation we had in the Sachsenring a couple of years ago. I mean, that was downright dangerous. You had like 20-odd guys trying to filter out and race, in effect, out of a pit lane that was about 10 metres wide. So there's no way we could have that scenario.
Here we see the discussion continuing. Team bosses all gathered around.
Yeah, could just see Loris Caparossi there as well, of course, MotoGP safety officer. Carlos Espeleta was also down there. Son of Dorna CEO Carmelo Espeleta. Jack Miller is still just sitting there on the grid waiting to find out what's going on. Are they being told now that they've got to come off the grid?
Yeah.
I've seen what happens when Aussies are told to leave the pub.
Yeah, we're going to volunteer you to be the one that tells Jack he's got to clear off the grid, Simon. There is obviously, I mean, in all seriousness, it's easy to joke, but this is a tricky situation because we've got representatives from each team. You can see Lucio Cecinella there. He's on the headset. He's on the radio now trying to communicate and relay information back to his LCR Honda camp just to give instructions to the likes of Christoph Bourguignon and Ramon Aurin, crew chiefs for Cal Crutchlow and Taka Nakagami, respectively, just to say this is how the show goes on.
And Simon, times like this as well, experience is crucial. You, as a rider, you've got to try and stay mentally strong here, haven't you, and relaxed.
Yeah, like right now, I don't think it's too hard because they've made the decision, you know. But earlier, yeah, that was stress and none of them wanted to talk. Every moment counted when you make the call to change tyres, you know, and you've got to keep, look at, you know what I'm saying, very difficult. But right now, they've already made their decision. They're already sitting here with their, except Jack, well, he's sitting there as well with his tyres he knows he needs to use. And it's quite easy because you know what time you've been given a time to leave the garage again. And I think right now it's not stressful. It will get stressful again if those spits of rain that I can feel get heavier.
See here Jack talking to movie star and Eurosport as well, and he's got a bit of a smile on his face as well.
Well, Jack Miller by now thought he'd be on about lap three of this Argentinian Grand Prix, but he has not moved an inch. But he's not giving up that pole position though, is he? He's milking this one, Jack.
The longest reign of pole position I've ever seen.
Discussions ongoing down in, this is on the grid. Michael Bartolomei now with Davide Brivio in close attention, and Francesco Guidotti. Francesco Guidotti will be talking himself hoarse at this rate because you can understand a little bit of frustration coming out from the Alma Pramac Ducati team.
Sorry, Simon.
No, I was going to say I genuinely feel sorry for Jack. He made the right call, you know, and he's not going to be able to take advantage of that. Well, it might not matter anyway now because that drizzle, light rain has returned.
You're joking. Please tell me you're joking.
I'm not joking.
Well, that will annoy Jack even more, I think it's fair to say. But it seems as though a decision has been made, and what the decision is, I guess we'll find out shortly. Some look happier about it than others. Gigi Delinea just being informed of the situation. Jorge Lorenzo walking out. He's about to go and have a look at pit wall. And I presume Jack Miller's just still on pole position.
Yeah.
Wow, bizarre. If you've just tuned in and you're wondering what's happening, then join the club. The race looked like it was going to start. Damp circuit. It was declared a wet race. And then everybody had gone for wets with the exception of Jack Miller. They then changed their mind. They've pulled themselves into pit lane. Too many then are going to exit pit lane and have to rejoin the back. It's a nightmare. Race start has been delayed due to safety conditions. We don't really know what's happening at this moment in time.
Well, we can see that certain TV crews are being allowed back onto the grid. Still no sign of anybody else apart from Jack Miller, who still sits tight in pole position.
Well, he's having a good old giggle. He's finding the funny side about it. He's just being told now what's happening.
Well, the earplugs are going in from Maverick Vinales, so he quite clearly has been told that something's going to be happening fairly sharpish. 7 minutes ago, this Argentinian Grand Prix should have got underway. And a delayed start, you can see on that tick across the bottom of your screen, due to safety conditions.
Guys, I'm with Danilo Petrucci. He's been kind enough to say a few words. I can feel the stress with the riders, but Danilo, how are you feeling? What do you think you're going to do?
I leave the pit for the first time with the slick tire, but I did the first lap and was a little bit too wet, so I come back immediately and go out with the rain tire. But when we was on the grid, the track got dry immediately, and everyone go out. Now I think we have to start from the last position, but I think we're gonna be strange, because every rider from the grid start from the last position, except from Jack. So now it's splitting again. It's some rain. Sincerely, I don't know. I have finished the energy for be sad or complaining is the same for everyone. I can even laugh at the moment.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course, what's happening now is there's going to be a revamp of the grid. Danilo Petrucci just saying there, he qualified 18th, but he's got to start last. So probably part of the explanation about the delay is the fact that the International Race Teams Association, in conjunction with Dorna, have been trying to work out now exactly where the riders are going to be lining up on the grid. I can see right in front of me a 29, a 46 and a 35. Well, that means that Valentino Rossi and Cal Crutchlow are way, way back, probably.
Well, that's the number four, Andrea Dovizioso. Number 41, Aleix Espargaró as well.
I can see a number nine on the back, what looks like now the new back row of the grid, although no, it's not. It's Petrucci, Bautista and Tom Luthi. So Petrucci's definitely having a revised grid position. Mike Webb is now starting to sprint back up the grid to take his place back in race control.
So everybody, so Jack Miller's going to get a handicap. I think that's basically the long and short of this. Because,
yeah, there are
no markings on what, how many rows?
It looks to me like there's, well, I can see Danny Pedrosa and what looks like being probably,
look, it's here, in front of our very eyes.
Yeah.
He's going to get a three-row head start or something. And I can't honestly say I've ever seen anything like this. I have never seen anything like this. That's more than a three rows. How many rows start is that?
Four. Or is it three?
Pit lane open at 3:15, which is in 5 minutes' time for a quick restart procedure.
Well, is that now the new second row? Zarco, Rabat and Rins?
Or no, Pedrosa's being pushed up here, number 26, right, so okay, he's yeah. going to resume where
well,
he was.
The thing is, his numbers being shuffled around all the time here.
Well, you are going to see one of the most bizarre starts to a race ever here in Argentina. What, I don't think that that's ever happened before.
No, I can never recall that scenario. I can see Andrea Dovizioso's number down in front of me. Now they're moving Dovizioso's number and Aleix Espargaró's number again. So they're just trying to exactly understand where everybody's going to start here. It looks like now everybody's being moved up one spot.
So just to give you an update on the weather, it's back to, I would start the race on dry tyres again. That drizzle has stopped and it slicks for sure.
Simon, is there any way of getting a word with Jack Miller? I mean, he's sitting on the grid at the moment. Looks pretty jovial.
Okay, I'll do my best. I'll get back down there.
He's got a head start. I bet he's never seen anything like this before, that's for sure. The Rossi fans there.
Well, I'll tell you what, Jack Miller's going to be in trouble if he's not leading into the first corner and doesn't get the whole shot.
Don't stall it. Whatever you do.
He's never going to get a better chance to get a MotoGP whole shot, is he, Jack Miller? So we might just be about there in terms of exactly where everybody's going to be lining up behind Jack Miller. The quick restart procedure starts then in about 2.5 minutes' time. And exactly yeah. what that means is, yeah, the pit lane's open for 60 seconds. You've got to then get out in that 60 seconds, come to the grid. You're allowed one mechanic on the grid in case you have any kind of issue, mechanically or technically, with the bike. When everything's okay, your one mechanic departs the scene, and away we go.
We're one lap short of the original distance, of course. It was set to be a 25-lap race. It's now 24. That doesn't really make an awful lot of difference at this stage. There is Dani Pedrosa getting ready to start, and all these guys just want to get out now. So, round two, at some point today, we're hoping we'll get underway. Still spitting lightly here and there, but still, from where we're standing, dry on circuit.
They're not letting me on the grid at the moment, guys. Jack's warming his bike up, and yeah, nobody allowed on, only people off.
Well, inadvertently, myself and Steve are going to get a brilliant look at the start of this race, because we can see the second row of the grid now, right outside our commentary position.
Oh, dearie me. I'm actually lost for words, to be honest, Matt. I am lost for words. In all the time I've watched World Championship Motorcycle Racing, I don't think I've ever seen a scenario where there's someone starting on pole and then a load of rows completely blank.
Well, I mean, how long's Jack Miller been sat there now for? A good half an hour. And finally, the tyre warmer's come off. He's had those slick tyres fitted for a long, long time. He gambled, he rolled the dice. Last minute, fist pumps and handshakes from his crew. All along, Jack Miller, never in any doubt, was on the slick tyres. This half an hour would have felt like a lifetime.
Guys,
for him.
I'm with Francesco Guidotti, the team manager of Jack. And Francesco, I imagine you're pretty disappointed the way things have gone.
Well, you know, I'm really satisfied, because satisfaction to have made the right choice in the right moment. Okay, it's not fair that 23 riders made the wrong choice, and for the show, for sure, it's not good. So, yeah, it's not, will be not a normal grid, but yeah, let's enjoy the race. Thank you.
Yeah, he was trying to put a positive spin on that, wasn't he, Francesco Guidotti? But I think reading between the lines, pretty frustrated. Why wouldn't he be? When all was said and done, he's still going to see Jack Miller start this Argentina Grand Prix from pole position. know what in terms of distance the advantage would be.
Drama here then in Argentina of the most unusual kind. The riders head out for a quick start procedure with Jack Miller on pole position and the others having made the wrong decision have been penalised and will start further back on the grid.
So the pit lane closes in 2 seconds, 1 second. The pit lane is now closed.
See the circuit here is looking pretty much bone dry. So at present, you're not going out there on anything other than slicks. Jack had made that call already. And now the question is, what are we going to get here in a 24 lap race? Will we see any more drizzle? Because that could really mess things up completely here.
Well, the run to the first corner for the photographers hoping for a bit of drama is going to be the weirdest first corner photos you've ever seen, because Jack Miller will be all on his Todd because he's got quite a big advantage at the start. Steve said a handicap for the other 23 riders.
Well, that would have never happened before, surely not. Look at that. Here we go then, the riders make their way round. The thing is, technically speaking, they're actually going by the rules here. Because, you know, all of these guys have made the wrong decisions. But all of these guys, what you're seeing actually is not second, third and fourth. It's the back of the grid.
It's quite a good advantage Jack's got up here, isn't it?
You're right, Steve, but you could argue that the reason why the flag-to-flag rule was implemented was because you pick your tyres to start the race with and then that's it. You go. And then if you want to change, you have to come in. That's the whole idea of a flag-to-flag scenario. I've never seen anything like this. This is unbelievable. What a strange, strange image. We had about six riders on the grid in the Saxon Ring 3 or 4 years ago.
And the reason why Pedrosa is starting halfway up the grid is because they've only got so many grid slots. And so they're just trying to bung as many on the back of the grid as possible. How odd this is. This is just a warm-up lap. Away we go. You're going to get some idea here of the advantage Jack will get into turn one. It's not mammoth, but it's a good advantage. I mean, he will almost certainly be into turn one on his own. Incredible stuff here in Argentina. Right, well, we're going to get going finally in a moment. 24 laps coming up. And now the question is, if it stays dry, Matt, look at that, the river running over there, still on the exit of turn three. These guys still don't actually know whether the tyres that they've chosen, dries, can actually work for them. Simon?
Guys, I'm impressed with the official's decision, you know, like Jack still gets to keep his advantage, you know, a good advantage, and it's a safe way of doing it rather than setting everyone else out from the pit lane like we were talking about.
The last MotoGP winners here in Argentina.
I suppose Jack Miller fans, though, will argue that, well, you start the race on the tyres that you choose, and then if you made the wrong call, you have to come in. That's part of the flag-to-flag scenario.
Yeah. It's certainly arguable. I mean, there's a lot of ways here that that we could look at this. I mean,
I think it's fair to say this one's going to be debated long into the night.
Oh, yes. Almost certainly.
We know some of the ones that will be doing it as well.
Andrea Dovizioso, the world championship leader on board with 32-year-old on the Ducati. Big day up ahead of him. And he's the coolest and calmest of them all. He probably will not have been affected by any of this one iota, and most won't, but one or two's focus might have just been detracted slightly by what's going on. Onto the grid we go. Jack Miller then lines up on pole position, and the rest of them starting from the back of the grid, but in order of where they qualified. How bizarre is this?
Well, I've just put my mortgage on Jack Miller getting the whole shot anyway, so
you better hope he doesn't stall it.
Oh, Marquez has got it. Marquez has stalled it.
Marquez has got a problem. Marquez has got a big problem here.
How much more?
Oh, he's got it going. He's got it going, but he might have to start from pit lane.
He's come off his grid position.
Is he? Pit lane. Yeah, he's got to start from pit lane. Unbelievable drama here. Or is he going back onto his grid slot? Hang on a minute. I thought he was being pointed to pit lane. Has he got away with that one?
I tell you what, guys, a lesser skilled person wouldn't have been able to start that bike on his own.
Cool. Where's Marc Marquez's head and his heart rate at right now? Seconds before the start of this Grand Prix.
24 laps in Argentina, and the strangest start you'll ever see. Jack Miller gets away from pole position and will almost certainly get the whole shot into turn one. Danny Pedrosa's second, Joan Zarco in third, and it looks like Marquez is regrouped and up into fourth place.
Yeah, he is. He's picked the pocket of Alex Rins in that first corner. Cal Crutchlow's got away well as two. He's riding contention. Valentino Rossi had a pretty sluggish start, as did Maverick Vinales. But as you'd expect, Jack Miller bolting away at the front. Pedrosa leading the pursuing pack.
Marquez will be thanking his lucky stars that he got that bike started. A big moment there for Joan Zarco as he ran across the water. And I think that he'll lose third. He does to Marc Marquez. It's Jack Miller that leads from Danny Pedrosa and then Marc Marquez.
Alex Rins having a dabble up the inside of Joan Zarco as well at turn five. Can't quite find his way through though. So it's Miller. The advantage he had with that staggered start was 0.8 seconds through the first sector.
Good start for Andrea Dovizioso. He made up a spot. He's in contention there. He just moved ahead of Tito Rabat as these guys now start to reel in Jack Miller.
Bradley Smith had a great first opening. Dovizioso's out wide at turn number seven, and that let Tito Rabat pounce. So a mistake early on for Andrea Dovizioso. Marquez up the inside of his teammate. There's no love lost there between Marquez and Pedrosa. Clinical by the world champion up the inside at turn number nine. He's through into second.
Up you get, Danny, said Marc Marquez. And whatever you say about Marc, that's got him going, that has. What's just happened to him on the grid? He's fired up properly because he might just lead here going into the final corner. And he's going to have a look up the inside and almost get his nose chopped off.
A touch between Zarco.
Pedrosa's gone.
He got nudged out wide by Joan Zarco and he's tried to squeeze the power on. On the wet surface, on the slick tyres, fingers crossed that Danny Pedrosa's not done another collarbone there. Massive high side, but he got nudged out wide by Joan Zarco. Pedrosa's race already over, and Miller now under real intense pressure from Marquez.
There's a big gap now where Pedrosa was. Alex Rins has inherited third place, and this is surely just a matter of time before Marc Marquez pounces. And you know what? We said yesterday they're going to have to beat Marquez up, and it's not going to happen.
Hopefully Danny Pedrosa's not experience another collarbone injury. Now, if Marc Marquez can quickly dispose of Jack Miller, we might have an exhibition ride here. Here he goes, out of the slipstream, effortless by the world champion. He's into the lead on lap number two. Marquez leads then, and he's had great pace all weekend, rain or shine, to make an escape.
Well, is this it? Is this goodbye, Marc Marquez, at the second round of the championship? The pace that he has shown in the dry, in the wet, has been astonishing. We're on board of him now, looking back at Jack Miller. His Ducati screaming for grip. Into turn 13 we go.
5 seconds before the lights went out, Marc Marquez was trying to bump start that Repsol Honda. He's ice cool. Nothing at all gets him flustered, does it? Amazing to regain his composure as quickly as he did. He's the master, isn't he? Getting out there and understanding track conditions, grip levels. It's still going to be a few damp patches out there right now, but Marc Marquez in position A, exactly where he wanted to be. Good news, it seems, for Danny Pedrosa. He is not injured, but this was Joan Zarco getting up the inside of him.
Oh, that is a bit cheeky. Zarco had nowhere of the room where to go, and unfortunately on the damp, on the power, winds it on, and that's all she wrote. Nasty, nasty crash. It's good news that Danny's okay, because that could have been collarbone.
Do you know what? I've seen so many times, unfortunately, in his long career, Danny Pedrosa have that kind of crash and snap a collarbone, so fingers crossed he's okay. Zarco actually just set the fastest lap of the race, a 1:42.869, slightly quicker than your race leader, Marc Marquez, but he's not found safe passage as yet through Alex Rins in third.
Cal Crutchlow's just stalking them as well. He's up there. Tito Rabat's doing very well in the early stages of this one.
What on earth has happened to Jorge Lorenzo as well? He's 23rd, Lorenzo. Last lap he did a 1:48.3. He's 23rd and last, 4 seconds behind Alvaro Bautista in front of him. Must have made a mistake somewhere, Lorenzo, surely.
The Yamahas are having an absolute mare, Matt. They are nowhere to be seen here in this front shot. Bit wide there from Rins. That allows Zarco to get closer.
Tito Rabat still holding firm against Andrea Dovizioso inside that top six. Last time around, Marquez about half a second faster.
Is that a white flag waving over there? What's that about? Where's that? So white flags waving. That just obviously means pit lane is open to make the change if you want. Sorry, yeah. Got confused. For a minute, I thought it was a white flag with a red cross.
If there's a red cross in it, start to panic.
Because that would be an issue. No one will be changing their bikes at this moment in time, that's for sure. So, here's Alex Rins and Joan Zarco.
Well, we know Joan Zarco. He showed it last year in his rookie season. He ruffled a few feathers, didn't he? It was aggressive up the inside of Dani Pedrosa. This is exactly where it happened. He's not going to find a way through against Alex Rins, who's holding firm, sitting tight in third place. This is allowing Cal Crutchlow to wedge ever closer to what would be his third podium finish here in Argentina. Marquez drops into the mid-144s. Fastest lap of the race, a 141.494. Half a second quicker than Miller.
Yeah, it's good stuff there. Miller's doing all right, actually, though, to hold on in there in the 141s himself.
A couple of real top rides inside the top 10. Tito about six, we've mentioned him before. There he's ahead of Andrea Dovizioso. Bradley Smith in 10th place. He's just been passed by Andrea Iannone on the factory Suzuki, but holding firm in that top 10 right now.
The manoeuvre at race start, currently under investigation. Well,
we saw one of the International Race Team Association officials quite clearly. We're not great lip readers, but he said pit lane.
That's what I thought.
No shadow of a doubt. We saw him say to Marc Marquez, pit lane.
Blimey, what's going on today? I tell you what, you could write a book about it. We've still got 21 laps to go. I mean, that would be an inquest and a half, wouldn't it? We'll keep you posted.
Well, if there's going to be any penalty, you want it to happen right now in the race. We don't want any retrospective penalties for Marc Marquez. If he's got to do a ride through, you know, give it to him now.
So, here is Andrea Dovizioso, seventh place for him, chasing down Tito Rabat. Behind him is a big gap back to Valentino Rossi. He's 2 seconds adrift of this lot. Andrea Iannone, he's not really been able to get his start together. He's just behind Valentino Rossi in ninth. Then it is, as Matt points out, a great ride from Bradley Smith. And then the two Aprilias, Aleix Espargaró and Scott Redding. Simon.
I'm with Hervé Poncharel. And Hervé, how are you feeling about the race right now, Juan's position?
Oh, I feel stressed, I think, like both of the team manager and the crews of the MotoGP grid. Was a bit of a strange procedure. The white flag is shown, so we can swap bikes anytime we want. We know there is still a few drops sometime in the air. I don't know what to say. It's going to be an interesting race. Unfortunately, we are a bit stuck behind Alex Rins. I think Joan has the pace to be maybe going with Jack. But anyway, we will see. It's going to be a long race because I think we will see a lot of things happening as we see now on screen in between Valle and Iannone. So not a lot to say, just heartbeat fast.
Thank you, Hervé.
Yeah, well, it's bye-bye Marc Marquez. He just took 9/10 of a second outside of Jack Miller on that last lap. 1.5 seconds clear he is now of the Australian. Andrea Iannone, he's picked off Valentino Rossi as well for eighth place. You can just see how much movement they had, the pair of them, as they got on the gas on that river of water running across turn number four. Big moments on the rear tyre for both Iannone and Rossi. And you can just see that at the back of your picture, Zarco just can't find his way through against Alex Rins for third.
I'm just interested to see what happens here with this Marquez situation and what happened at the start of the race, because I'm almost certain that he was told to walk off the grid there, and there will be a huge inquest about that. But anyway, for now, we read what we see. This is Alex Rins, just ahead of Joan Zarco in the battle for third.
Now, I can see Rick Crichton from the International Race Teams Association, Steve. He's just been down to chat to the Repsol Honda team. Now, whether that is any kind of signal about a possible sanction for Marc Marquez.
Yeah, well, we can't tell you. Yeah, he's got a ride-through penalty. It's just come through. Marc Marquez has got a ride-through penalty.
I just saw Rick Crichton there from the International Racing Association. He's gone down to communicate. Now I can see Marc Marquez's team are being told to pitboard him. They can obviously send him a message on his dashboard as well. I can see now Marc Marquez's mechanic ride through is going on the board. Alberto Puig looks absolutely incensed. There we go. Marc Marquez is going to get a ride through. There we are. Race direction. It's on his dashboard. He's also going to get the pitboard. How much more drama can you take, folks, in Argentina?
Oh, blimey, I thought he had a moment there as well. This is just incredible. It's so confusing. One of the most bizarre races you're ever likely to see. I have to say, in a way, I'm not surprised to see that after what happened on the grid. It's a very, very confusing situation, but if you're told to get off the grid and then you read and you start the race, I suppose you have to expect a penalty, but this will be talked about yep. for a long time. And look, let's be honest, Matt, this is massive penalty as well, because...
Well, that's it. He's not going to get on the podium, is he? Not at all.
And this is a huge lifeline for the likes of Andrea Dovizioso, who, quite frankly, has not got the pace to even challenge for a podium here. This will put Jack Miller out front now. Well, has he seen it? And when does he go in? He has to go in.
His dashboard. He's got to come in, really. I think you get
two laps, is it?
He's in.
Unbelievable stuff, this. Can you believe it? Jack Miller won't believe his eyes as he now comes through and over the line to lead the Grand Prix of Argentina.
Quite clearly, we saw on the grid, pit lane came out of the words of the IRTA officials.
Well, race win chances gone for Marc Márquez. And you can see the damage that it's doing.
What a day. What an afternoon of drama here in Argentina, the MotoGP World Championship. We've had half a season's worth of entertainment and drama so far. Márquez then, got to be careful there coming out of pit lane. It's going to be really greasy on that blue paint on the outside. So he's rejoined just in front of Carol Abraham. Oh, sorry, Álvaro Bautista.
In 19th place then for Marc Márquez. Now, when he was based gone. On his blistering speed, he can almost certainly get himself into the top 10. Of that, there's very little doubt.
Look at this, he won't even be in the top four of the championship.
Now,
this
here
is what
we
happened.
Go. He stalls the bike on the grid. Can't get it going. Eventually gets it going. He's told by an IRTA official.
Pit lane.
To go into pit
here
lane.
Here comes technical director Danny Aldridge.
Yep,
they're also trying to direct
pit
him
lane,
off.
And he's not going.
You can see, I think Cal Crutchlow was there as well, saying surely he's got to start from pit lane. Maverick Viñales is getting pretty frustrated. What an Argentinian Grand Prix. This one's going to be talked about and live long in the memory for a long, long time. What it all means, though, after all that drama involving Marc Márquez, riding the opposite direction. Of course, yeah, he turned the bike around. Turned the bike around, didn't he?
So there's two penalties there, effectively, because one, he'd been told to get off anyway, and then he's ridden the bike on the wrong direction on the grid as well. You cannot write this stuff. What we can say is there's 17 laps to go here in Argentina. Jack Miller leads from Alex Rins and Joan Zarco, and then Cal Crutchlow. This is not a podium battle that you would have written or predicted at the start of the weekend. Dovizioso crosses the line in fifth ahead of Tito Rabat.
Andrea Dovizioso is playing his get-out-of-jail-free card here, because he has been nowhere near the pace of this man, Marc Márquez. Márquez was checking out, he was long gone. This was going to be a cruise to the victory for the reigning world champion. But that key mistake, stalling it on the grid, he's probably never done that in his entire Grand Prix career. What a time to do it.
Have you ever seen anything like this in your entire life? This is your fight for the win up here. Jack Miller is leading. He was on pole position. He's never had a dry race win.
A lot of people, Steve, will feel a Jack Miller victory will be fully vindicated here after the problems at the start of the race. You can see Alex Rins there spinning up that rear tyre on the factory Suzuki. This four are well clear of Andrea Dovizioso in fifth. The Qatar winner 7.5 seconds behind Cal Crutchlow in fourth place. You can still see a few damp patches littered all around this Turmaster Rio Hondo circuit.
All the cameras and journalists at the moment gathered round, guess who? The Repsol Honda pit wall and Alberto Puig, who is at the moment going to need a fire extinguisher to be put out because he's absolutely livid with what's going on. Marc Márquez is still in 19th place at present.
Guys, I think there's a higher risk than normal of a crash for Márquez, because the last thing I want to happen, but you know, when he's so far down now, he knows how fast he is. I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to pull something extra out to make up some time, see what he can do for the championship. But it's also a big risk in this condition.
Well, what a day for MotoGP. What a day for the Repsol Honda team. Danny Pedrosa out early after a tangle with Joan Zarco. Big crash high side for him at turn number 13. And Marc Márquez, a ride-through penalty for stalling on the grid and then turning round on the grid and coming back the opposite way to rejoin the grid. Such high drama. He's just fired in the fastest lap of the race. He's a mile quicker than anybody else, a 140.2. Exactly a second quicker than Jack Miller. Márquez is 19th at the moment. He's 20 seconds behind Miller, but a second faster. 16 laps to go.
Look at this. Hafiz Syahrin up behind Valentino Rossi. The Malaysian is riding
Marquez can
unbelievable.
Get in the top five here.
Easily.
He's got the pace. He'll be in the top five. With a ride through. He's having a laugh, isn't he?
He's closing in here on Scott Redding. And he might just make light work of this, Marc Marquez, to move. Sorry, is that Aleix? It's Aleix, isn't it? Sorry. In 18th place. Oh, he's pushing that front end. You just saw a bit of opposite lock there from Mark Simons. Right. He'll be a bit angry. He's pushing that front. He's got to be careful here because there are definite points on offer. But then careful and Marc Marquez kind of don't really go together.
Last time around, he was 3.7 seconds faster than Aleix Espargaró. He's going to gobble up his fellow Spanish rider, pretty sharpish. And then the next in his eye line will be Taka Nakagami.
Whoa! And that was almost curtains for the pair of them. Marc Marquez saw a gap. Surely it wasn't big enough. He almost did. He puts his arm up. It was his mistake. Goodness me. He really is the cat.
Well, where's Aleix Espargaró in Brazil? I mean, that was aggressive. Goodness. Aggressive in the extreme by Marc Marquez. He's trying. He knows that there's a top five up for grabs here with his pace. That would have cost him a lot of time. A couple of seconds, in actual fact. Back at the front with Jack Miller. Miller, Rin, Zarco and Crutchlow. This is your quartet fighting for the victory. Two riders in that quartet trying to find their first victory in MotoGP. Jack Miller's a winner in Aston 2 years ago. Cal Crutchlow, a winner in Silverstone and Phillip Island 2 years ago. Alex Rins. Johan Zarco, not yet broken their Premier Class duck. They'll not have a better chance than this one.
Watch this. That's, oh, blimey.
That's a, you know, I'm not really quite sure what Marquez thinks he can achieve there because there's no room whatsoever.
Well, there was no gap.
There's no gap there.
But,
I mean, look at that. There's no room at all.
He's left it just a bit too late to break. The door's been closed. I don't know. It's hard to say what can happen here. I mean, there's just about everything. You think of anything that can happen, and it probably will here in a few moments. Incredible stuff. I cannot believe what's happening. Here's Alberto Puig.
He's got no fingernails left, Alberto. He's down to the knuckles in a minute.
This is the battle for the lead then. Pinch me. Am I watching this? What's happening? Jack Miller leads across the line. 14 to go ahead of Alex Rins, looking for his first win. Likewise, Zarco. Cal Crutchlow will believe he can win this in fourth.
You know what, Steve, as well? Marquez doesn't need to be that hasty. He's so much quicker.
He's got to drop a position. So he's got to drop one position now for that move. Just about everything is happening.
Yeah, it was... Has he ever had a more eventful Grand Prix than this? Probably, what, Phillip Island in 2013, maybe? When he missed the pit lane window for the mandatory pit stop. He's up the inside now, Franco Morbidelli. He's carving his way through the field.
But he's about to be told that he's got to drop a position, and there he does.
There you go, straight away, yeah.
Well, that's not really going to cost
him too
much.
But he just gained that position, so has he got to drop back one other place? Morbidelli surely is not the position.
I think it just says drop one position. It doesn't say who, does it? Blimey, just about every rule in the book needs to be looked at here. Is Marc Marquez, he's dropping again.
But
now.
He doesn't know. He doesn't know who he's got to drop behind. That's the problem. I think he passed Morbidelli and then saw the penalty.
So here we go. Oh, he's making Taka Nakagami sit up as well. This is carnage of epic proportions. I have never seen anything like this.
That's the motorcycling version of a hot butter through knife, isn't it? I think he just got momentarily confused there about exactly which place he was supposed to be dropping or who he was supposed to drop him behind.
Bizarre. 14 laps to go. At the front, there's still no change. It is Miller and Rins.
I was just about to say, Steve, you know, he didn't need to be that hasty. He had blistering speed. He was way, way quicker than everybody else, but that's the Marquez way, isn't it? Super aggressive all the time, every single lap he's out there.
Maverick Vinales is one to look out for at the moment. He's on a bit of a charge. There's the gap to these guys is probably a bit too big, but he might well be in a fight for fifth place soon. Jack Miller, the Australian, leads. 12 years ago yesterday, Casey Stoner made his debut in MotoGP, and he got pole.
Nothing in the lap times between the top four at all. In fact, it was a 141.0 for Miller, 141.1 for Rins, a 141.2 for Zarco, and a 141.3 for Cal Crutchlow.
Two Movistar Yamaha riders, Vinales and Rossi, have passed Tito Rabat. They're now into sixth and seventh, respectively.
Yeah, Rabat's struggling. He's about to get swallowed up by Hafiz Syahrin as well. What a ride by the Malaysian. He's about to pick up Rabat and move into eighth place.
There is Andrea Dovizioso, and in the background, just heading onto the back straight, there is Marc Márquez. It looked like he's almost on the grass there, trying every which way he can to get by. Now, Maverick Viñales is going to make light stuff here of Andrea Dovizioso, and Dovizioso is in a bit of bother here. He's in a little bit of bother with this lot.
Yeah, Viñales and Rossi have got good rhythm. They were a fraction faster last time around. What will be even worse, and what will really kick Andrea Dovizioso wise down? Talk about rubbing salt in his wounds if he gets swallowed up by Marc Márquez after a ride through penalty and dropping back one position. That will really stick with Dovizioso. And Mahoy Lorenzo, what happened to him early on? 21st for Lorenzo. He's 35 seconds back of your race leader, Jack Miller. Nightmare.
So the battle you're watching, believe it or not, is not for the lead with Dovizioso, Viñales and Rossi. This is the fight for fifth place. Marc Márquez is back in 15th, having had a ride through penalty. This is how the championship looks. Jack Miller are going to second place.
It's going to change pretty sharpish though, because Andrea Dovizioso's got half the race to hold off the likes of Viñales and Rossi, who are really coming through. Márquez then now is back in the points. He's 14th. Marc Márquez last time around a 141.1.
Here comes Alex Rins in the slipstream of Jack Miller for the race lead with 12 to go. Alex Rins, the rookie of last year, he can't quite outbreak Jack Miller into turn five. Not enough room there. Just runs slightly wide as well, and that's just behind. Zarco looked like he went a bit wide. Crutchlow still in fourth. Crutchlow can't quite get his claws into these three.
He's pushing Cal as well, though. He was the only rider, quickest rider on the circuit last time around. The only man in the 140s, a 149.20. You're not going to slipstream a Ducati down that long back straight. Ducati, horsepower city on that back straight through turns four and five, and Alex Rins just couldn't quite get close enough. Next in Marquez's sights is Pol Espargaró. He's just under 2 seconds behind his fellow Spaniard in 13th place. Marquez is 7 seconds adrift of Andrea Dovizioso in fifth, and last time around he was a second quicker. Time in his pocket here, Marc Márquez, to easily get himself into that top five.
Alex Rins looking in good shape here. The Suzuki rider into turn 13, a bit of a front-end wobble. Rins eyeing up his first win in MotoGP and Suzuki's first since Maverick Viñales 2 years ago at Silverstone.
Well, his pit board there said plus two Zarco, G2, which means group two. I'm not quite sure that's technically accurate. It's a full rider fight. Well, maybe just telling him that there's only two riders actually behind him.
On board now with Maverick Viñales, looking at the moment, the championship leader, Andrea Dovizioso.
141.46 has just been hammered in by Marc Márquez, another fastest lap of the race. In a lap, he's taken 1.7 seconds out of Pol Espargaró immediately ahead of him, so he's going to swallow up the KTM man
and has
really, really quickly.
It's already done. He's up to 13th, Marc Márquez, as we watch this fight for fifth place, as Dovizioso screams to try and get the power on the Ducati. He's bucking and weaving down the back straight, but look at the power of the red machine.
Yeah, and Marc Márquez is about to pass Scott Redding as well.
Here comes the change for the lead. Alex Rins up the inside, but he runs wide. Through goes Jack Miller again. That allows Zarco and Crutchlow just to get a bit closer.
Yeah, Márquez has taken Redding. He's just passed Redding, and in the blink of an eye, taking a second out of the British rider on the factory Aprilia. Petrucci now the next victim for Márquez, surely. Not a case of if, but when.
Marc Márquez, if he can keep the rest of this race clean, which is saying something given what he's had so far, could easily get fifth place here. He could catch that group for fifth.
Well, it's not good news for Marc Márquez, Steve. It's good news for the fans watching at home, because if Marc Márquez had not had that penalty, he would be absolutely all on his own, 10 seconds clear of this race at this stage.
Anything can happen.
Viñales has taken Dovizioso. Viñales ended up in the fifth place. So Andrea Dovizioso losing another point there.
Márquez. Oh, and he's gone wide and allowed Rossi through as well, costing precious points.
Márquez in the flash. 1.5 seconds quicker last time around than Danilo Petrucci. sitting ducks those guys in front of Marc Márquez at the moment. And Rins is through. Alex Rins has found a way through then on the factory Suzuki. He leads here in Argentina, but he's wide again. Second time in successive laps, he's about to lose second place. Is he? No, he slams the door shut on Joan Zarco, but that's the second bite of the cherry that he's had. Alessio Spargo's retired.
Oh, look at the smoke pouring out of the rear tyre there of Alex Rins. Brilliant stuff there from the Suzuki rider.
So Alessio Spargo dropped out of the points with a fueling issue in Qatar, and he's had to retire here as well in Argentina. So a dismal start of the year for the factory Aprilia man.
It's Ducati versus Suzuki versus Yamaha versus Honda.
Cal Crutchlow's just not been able to get close enough to show Joan Zarco a wheel, as he has yet.
Is he saving himself?
He might just be keeping a bit of life in those tyres. We can see Rins and Miller are starting to move around quite a lot, certainly with their rear tyre. Rins again having a few stability issues coming through turn 12.
Carl Crutchlow had to back out of that. He had more speed than Zarco going into 13. That could have been very close indeed. Of the four riders that go across the line here, Cal is the more experienced at these leading packs.
Marc Márquez is about to go into the top 10. He's picked off Petrucci and he's about to pick off Andrea Iannone. Andrea Iannone will not be liking this one bit, seeing his teammate Alex Rins a long, long way up the road and fighting for Suzuki's second victory in the MotoGP era.
Márquez is 10th.
Ah, he's got Iannone. He's passing these guys like they're standing still. Iannone really, really struggling. Petrucci's now picked him up at the first corner. So Márquez is now 4 seconds behind Maverick Viñales in fifth place.
Here comes Rins again. He's not leaving a lot of room there for Jack Miller. Can this time he pull it up and hold on? He runs slightly wide again on cutback, and there goes Jack Miller through again, retaliating.
These two have had some battle royales back in the Moto3 days. That's brave. How brave was that by Alex Rins, picking Jack Miller's pocket through turn number 6.
There's smoke pouring everywhere, moves being chucked around. Cal Crutchlow wants in on the action now. He's seen enough. It's time to go. Cal's trying desperately here to find a way past Joan Zarco.
First time in the race you've really seen Crutchlow having a few issues with that rear tyre. It's just starting to spin up and get a bit loose on Crutchlow now as he gets on the gas, certainly coming out of turn number 8.
Who wants it the most? Alex Rins looking for his first victory. Zarco likewise. Jack Miller, of course, the winner in Assen. And here comes Crutchlow. He's had to go the long way round there. It's not going to quite work out. He's so much later on the brakes than Zarco, but Zarco's got the line.
Just letting Zarco know exactly where he is. Márquez now 9th. He's taken Happy Siren. Lap 17 underway. 8 to go here in Argentina. Rins, Miller, Zarco and Crutchlow. Only one factory bike. Although actually Carl Crutchlow, of course, on the 2018 RC213V. Here's Dovizioso, who's just fired in a personal best lap of the race, but he's struggling to go with Rossi and Viñales, and who's now hunting him down? Who's stalking him from behind? Marc Márquez, who, let's not forget, has had a ride through the pit lane here in Argentina, and he's about to try and overtake Andrea Dovizioso for 7th place. That's going to be demoralising for Dovizioso.
It is, but it could have been so much worse for Dovizioso, and I think that if anyone could take the positives out of that, it would be him. He should be winning this race by 30, 40 seconds, and it's not going to happen. Here is Alex Rins then, he leads. There's a precious prize on offer here for one of these four riders.
Good job Alex Rins has honed his motocross skills in the winter because he's really lighting up that rear tyre. Crutchlow then pounces. Cal Crutchlow makes his move and Rins was well wide. Big mistake by Rins. In the blink of an eye, goes from first to fourth place. Miller now leads, Crutchlow second.
It's fair to say that if Alex Rins continues to smoke his rear tyre like he is, with 8 laps to go, he's going to be out of contention for this. He's going to have to be careful with that. Cal Crutchlow then smells blood. Here we go. He's now up behind his good mate, Jack Miller. He's got experience of winning races.
Crutchlow may have just done an awesome job here of nursing his tyres for a late charge. On paper, in the rain or the dry, the closest rival to Marc Márquez was Cal Crutchlow. Cal was always fancying his chances of coming through from 10th on the grid to take the fight to Marc Márquez, and Crutchlow and Miller both dive into the 140s.
The gap between Dovi and Márquez further back for 7th is just under a second, but it won't be that for long. Cal Crutchlow trying to close in on Jack Miller. Joan Zarco there as well. All of these guys pack a pretty big punch.
That barbecue Alex Rins was cooking up on that rear tyre as he just now running out of steam, and Zarco gets that Yamaha. Oh, look at that, all of them, they're having such movement now on the rear tyre. Crutchlow and Zarco, big, big moments on the rear tyres. They've got on the gas coming through turn number four.
Zarco tried to outbrake Crutchlow. Crutchlow trying to desperately rein the Honda in, and does so. The LCR Castrol Honda rider now closing back up onto the tail of Jack Miller, who started on pole position.
Well, we should remember, Steve, of course, we're getting into the realms of, oh, here we go, Marquez on Dovizioso. Well, it was coming and it's finally happened. Penny for Andrea Dovizioso's thoughts right now, because he's just been swallowed up by Marc Marquez down at turn number five. Marc Marquez now into seventh place. The two factory Yamahas ahead of him. Bradley Smith crashed out at the first corner. Smith was fighting with Franco Morbidelli for 16th place.
Joan Zarco starting to get a bit tasty now, and Cal Crutchlow knows that it's now or never to pounce on his friend Jack Miller.
These guys have not put this amount of laps, Stephen, on slick tyres this weekend. 25 or 30 laps they did on slick tyres on Friday.
Oh, it's a big bump and a wobble there from Jack Miller. He almost lost the front, and in turn, Cal Crutchlow bites. He goes through, Zarco through, Rins is through as well. And all of a sudden, Cal Crutchlow not only leads the race, but he leads the championship right now as well.
Yeah, yellow flags for the Bradley Smith incident there, so no overtaking allowed. So, who's got the life in the tyre? These tyres under the stresses that they've never been before this weekend. Jack Miller, that was really, really costly. Marquez has just fired a 140.055. He's going to easily catch Valentino Rossi in sixth place.
Now we're going to find out if Cal's been saving a bit of tyre. They're all desperately struggling for grip on the back straight.
When they're getting the gas on through turn number four, you can see Crutchlow's having some big, big moments on that rear tyre.
Maverick Vinales is at the moment in fifth, but he'll do well to hold on to that. Marc Marquez is coming. Fifth place is his. This is the battle for the lead, though.
He loves Argentina, Cal Crutchlow. He's had two podium finishes here before.
And Jack Miller's gone. I don't think he's going to be able to catch that back up again, Matt. That mistake, or a wobble in the moment, into turn 13. If you watch this, just as he starts to get on the brakes, he has a moment on the front, almost tucks it, has to sit the bike up a bit.
What happened there was he was trail braking with a lot of lead angle, and he just hit that wet line. And he just took the front end. He was pretty fortunate to stay on board. There is Lucio Cecinella looking on pretty anxiously. He's seen Cal Crutchlow, a double winner in the MotoGP World Championship 2 years ago.
But he's got the hungry and fiery Frenchman behind, Joan Zarco, who's on the hunt for his first ever victory.
Yeah, you talk about dogs with bones. Joan Zarco's not going to give this one up at all.
One of the LCR mechanics waving Crutchlow along as if he's not trying hard enough already. The bulldog determination coming through here for Cal Crutchlow.
Crutchlow a tenth faster than Zarco last time around. Nothing between the pair, and they were slightly quicker, 3/10 faster than Alex Rins. Yeah, Miller's really suffering here. He's dropped down almost into the 142s as Miller. Marc Marquez now within a second of Valentino Rossi. Marquez is definitely going to be picking up probably a fifth place, certainly top six. Crutchlow's having massive moments coming through that turn four. Huge moments.
Complete and utter passenger. As he goes over that river is Cal Crutchlow. This is a season-changing result coming up here for one of these three. Season-changing.
When was the last time a British rider led the Premier Class World Championship? You're probably going to be going back all the way to the days of Barry Sheen.
Dr. Martin Raines, please get in touch, because that'll be a question asked by so many people. Here we go then, here's Marc Marquez. He's closing in on Valentino Rossi, who will not believe his eyes when he sees Marc Marquez flying past him, but it's likely to happen here. The Movistar Yamaha duo have had a pretty dim weekend, it's fair to say, here in Argentina. They were first and second here last year, and they are nowhere near first and second here today. They're fifth and sixth at the moment, but it's about to get worse, because this man is flying at the front. Quarter of a second gap. Crutchlow still leads from Zarco. What a ride this is from Siren, by the way.
Yeah, and Tito Rabat in ninth place. I think that would actually equal Tito Rabat's best finish in MotoGP. It would.
Zarco leads. Zarco's got the lead. We're watching here Marquez. Oh, he's gone. He's going to knock him off. Oh, on earth has he done it? He's done it again.
Oh, and Rossi's on the grass.
And that's Marquez's crash again. He's done exactly the same thing again.
Well, There's history, and there's a lot of history between the pair of them. It started here in Argentina back in 2015. Clear contact between Marc Márquez and Valentino Rossi at turn number 13. Rossi nudged onto the grass, soaking wet grass, nothing he could do. Down the road he goes, race direction. Mike Webb has now got another monumental headache. What does he do?
Meanwhile, at the front, Zarco's taken the lead. He went past Cal Crutchlow, and Rins is now closing into the party as well. We've got four laps to go, and I don't know which way to look.
Where do you start on this Argentinian Grand Prix? Rossi's remounted, grass stuck in all the right-hand side of that factory Yamaha. He's rejoined the race. Here we go, Marc Márquez up the inside.
Exactly the same thing as he did earlier.
No room there.
Oh, mate, well, this...
He knows it, because, yeah, there's no room. He's going to get another penalty. He has to get another penalty. He clattered the latest Spargaro. He's now clattered Valentino Rossi. Rossi on the floor. And as we said, there is an awful lot of history between those two. That's going to rumble on long into the night, way, way beyond this Argentinian Grand Prix. Where do you start with the talking points here in Termas?
This is just incredible. You just don't know. Whether you need eyes in the back of your head. Simon?
Just to let you know, these three we're looking at now, they have all the same rear tyres on, medium. On the front, only Zarco has the soft. The other two have medium.
Yeah, no surprise, Zarco went for the soft front there, but it's all just down to this. There's three laps to go, they're all hungry for victory.
And no surprise that straight away the incident involving Marc Márquez and Valentino Rossi under investigation. Not the first time we've had that ticker running across the bottom of the screen in the MotoGP World Championship.
Vinales is fifth, Márquez is still out there in sixth. The gap is 3.4 seconds, he's being told.
Are they rain spots on Maverick Vinales' visor? Or am I just... Is my eyesight going after this epic MotoGP race? Cal Crutchlow's just running out of rear tyre here. Coming through turn number four, he's a passenger. It's a fucking Bronco, that LCR Honda.
Here we go into the back straight. Alex Rins then looking for his first win, and so is Johann Zarco. Crutchlow, can he hold on to try and fight? Zarco at the moment, who has been talked about so much in the off-season, could finally be getting himself that winner's trophy.
This has been an unbelievable race, unbelievable. So much drama, so much action, and it's not over yet. Rins fighting back. We thought he was out of it, but Alex Rins coming back into contention.
Ah, oh, Crutchlow up the inside. Brilliantly done. And I'll tell you what, whilst this lot chop and change, Jack Miller will get invited back into this potentially.
They're all riding on eggshells now. They've just got zero grip, all three of them. Simon.
Guys, how many times does Márquez get away with doing something like that before the black flag comes out? I think that's what they'll be thinking of, surely.
Well, there's
going to be a penalty coming. You can't go around just barging into riders like he did. And again, he was so much quicker than Rossi. He didn't need to do it. There was no room. Rossi was on the racing line. Did not need to do it. Another couple of corners, he was going to quite comfortably pass Valentino Rossi. No dramas.
For now, we have to put that to the back of our mind, because there's a race for victory here in Argentina. And it's between one of these three. Johann Zarco, the Frenchman on satellite Yamaha, the LCR Castrol Honda rider Cal Crutchlow, and Alex Rins. Two of them have never had a win before. One knows all about the feeling.
Well, we're coming out of the part of the circuit where Cal Crutchlow really struggles on the right-hand side of that tyre. Look at him again, speedway style coming through turn number three. Let's have a look at Crutchlow through turn number four.
That was a lot smoother for Cal Crutchlow, yep. And he's in the slipstream now. Zarco wasn't so clean, and out of the slipstream comes Cal Crutchlow, and he leads again. That's just about the cleanest Crutchlow's come out of turn three and four for the entire race.
Crutchlow should be stronger on the front end as well, with Zarco running that soft option front tyre.
So they power out. What a race we've seen here in Argentina, and it's not done yet. Not by a long stretch. A lap and a half to go.
Marc Márquez has just fired in the fastest lap of the race. It might be completely irrelevant as far as he's concerned. Surely there's another sanction coming his way. Mike Webb under massive scrutiny here. What did he do with the reigning world champion after that incident with Valentino Rossi? Shades of 2015 all over again. Crutchlow, can he make the decisive break?
It's been bizarre, it's been brilliant, it's been confusing, there's been moments everywhere. I don't know where to begin. Valentino Rossi here is in 19th place. He ain't scoring points today, I'm afraid. It's all about the battle at the front that we want to see. Vinales at the moment holds the gap of fifth, but this is what we want to see, because we're about to start the final lap here in Argentina. They flick left onto the start-finish straight. Cal Crutchlow leads from Johann Zarco and Alex Rins.
It's way, way more than 20 years since a British rider has won
or has led the MotoGP World Championship. It's nearly 20 years since a French rider was victorious in the Premier Class. Regis Laconi way, way back in 1999. It looks like a showdown between Crutchlow and Johann Zarco. Back to Maverick Vinales and Marc Marquez. This is a battle for fifth place. Marquez really hunting down Vinales. Back at the front still, Crutchlow holds firm. Coming now through turn number four.
This is crucial over the water. Can he keep it steady? He does. It's a bit of a moment there, but Zarco's coming in the slipstream. That was the fastest lap of Cal's race so far. He fired in a 140.3. Can he stay in front of Zarco at the end of the back straight? Yes, for now.
Zarco's coming. He thought about it. Zarco thought about how much abuse, how much force he's putting through that soft option front tyre. Zarco's going to be close enough maybe to attack at that final couple of corners. Crutchlow holds firm though. They come through turn number six, spinning that rear tyre. Still Crutchlow. Rins is out of it. Rins is not going to surely get back into contention. Crutchlow versus Zarco, turn seven.
Two of the biggest fighters that you could ever wish to meet here. Cal Crutchlow, Johann Zarco, all looking for an extra inch here and there. There's bound to be a move coming at turn 13. There's got to be.
It's all about the drive now. The side grip you've got coming through turn number 12. Crutchlow still in that final sector, standing firm. Cal Crutchlow then now. Couple of corners to go for the British rider. Zarco out of picture. Can Zarco get close enough? Zarco's not going to be close enough. It's going to be a desperate lunge. Crutchlow, surely, it's going to win here in Argentina.
Or has he run wide? No, it's a bit wobbly, but surely it's done. He's just got one corner left. And here in Argentina, what a race it's been. Cal Crutchlow wins for the LCR Castrol Honda team ahead of Johann Zarco in one of the most incredible races you will ever see. Third place goes to Rins, Miller fourth. Vinales has been robbed of fifth at the end by Marc Marquez, but as for whether that stands is another question.
Yeah, that's another story. Jubilation for the LCR Honda team. Andrea Dovizioso crosses the line in seventh place, 22 seconds back of the winner. Great job by Tito about his career best in MotoGP 8. Johann Zarco threw everything at Cal Crutchlow on that last lap. His fastest lap of the race from Zarco, a 140.425. It just wasn't enough, though, to close down on Cal Crutchlow. Valentino Rossi, he came over the line in 19th place, and there's going to be plenty more talking points to follow this unbelievable, incredible, sensational 24-lap Argentinian Grand Prix. Where do you start? The delayed start, Jack Miller on his lonesome on pole position, Marquez penalised for stalling on the grid, then incorrectly turning back on the grid, punting out Aleix Espargaró, then a collision, a 30-second penalty. When was the last time a rider had three penalties in a race? Three different penalties in a race? I can't recall it.
I'm going to have a lie down. I can't keep up with this.
Well, 30 seconds puts him out of the points. He had no way could he have not have got away with that one. I'm sorry, you don't get away with that. There's no room, absolutely no room. Valentino Rossi's on the line. There's no room at all for Marc Marquez, and he didn't need to do it. He was way, way quicker than Rossi. And Rossi's on the grass with lean angle, soaking wet grass. There's only one outcome there. Marc Marquez knows, he'll be looking around there going, whoops, I'm in big trouble here.
Well, it's begun. 2018 is here, Matt, I think it's fair to say, and there is a lot to mull over and chew over. That's the onboard from Rossi. I'm afraid you cannot not be penalised for that.
I mean, that is what they say, irresponsible riding, causing danger to another rider. There's no way he can declare that a racing incident. He clattered him. He clattered Aleix Espargaró as well in the same corner.
Either way, Cal Crutchlow is the victor here. And for the first time in how many years, I do not know. I'm pretty sure Cal Crutchlow is going to be leading the world championship here.
You've got to be going back to probably the days of Barry Sheen, haven't you, in the late 70s. Third win of his MotoGP career then for Cal Crutchlow. His third podium finish actually here as well in Argentina. And he survived the most intense onslaught on the last lap from Johann Zarco. You've got to give full credit to Zarco, because all three of them on the podium, you could quite clearly see they had zero grip, front and rear. And Zarco, well, he put in, it was all in, wasn't it? As Marquez is famous saying, all in. There is Marquez back in the garage. Let's not forget, Marc Marquez in that race had three completely different penalties.
Look at Cal, look how pumped he is about that, and rightly so. What a race! That was all three riders. Blimey, that would have hurt. Oh, there you go.
Yeah, he's. I think it's fair to say that Cal Crutchlow's pumped, I think would be the ultimate word.
Well, Joan Zarco, a valiant second. Great job for Alex Rins, by the way. His first podium in MotoGP. Joan Zarco, well, you can't fault their effort. They've all put 110% into this one.
Cal Crutchlow was a former Monster Yamaha Tech 3 rider. They've never won a Premier Class race, the French-based team. And Cal Crutchlow's made sure that that record goes on. There's going to be some pretty fierce discussions about what we've just seen. I mean, that race winning time, 40 minutes and 36 seconds, we've crammed in to that 40 minutes and a half, half a season's worth and more of drama. It was truly, truly unbelievable.
Confirmation has come through that Marquez will finish in 18th place as a result of that penalty.
Well, I'll tell you what, not that the best defence lawyer in the world is not going to get him off the hook on those ones.
Alex Rins, his first of many podiums, and there's a bit of chatting to do
now. Is he going to Rossi's garage? Is he going down to see Valentino Rossi to apologise? Now, this is going to be one that our camera guys are going to be wanting not to be missing.
Cameras, do not switch away from this.
He's going. Now, this is brave. And I've got to say, massive respect. Fair play to Marc Marquez for going down into the box. Whether Valentino Rossi wants to accept his apology, Ucho Salucci there. Valentino Rossi's great friend. Emilio Alzamora, Marquez's mentor, and Alberto Puig. Well, there you go. Marquez has gone down to the box to apologise, and this is a long-running feud. There's a lot of bad blood. People say it's all water under the bridge from 2015 between those two. No, it's not.
I'm afraid, ladies and gentlemen, if you thought the feud was over, it's back on. But we should not take away from what's happened here. We've got to talk about it because Marquez would have probably smashed this race in so many other ways. But it's not what's happened. What is on your screen is what has happened. And there...
He's a brave man, Marc Marquez. Fair play to him for going down to try and apologise, but quite clearly... Maybe they'll let their paths will cross at some point in Termas later on.
Goodness me, I just don't even know where to begin here. Oh, get me a dark room.
Pretty much lost for words. I mean, that was just truly an incredible hour and a half, hour and 20 minutes. Alex Rins, after all of that, Alex Rins, his first ever podium in the MotoGP World Championship. Big smiles all round and why not? Congratulations to Alex Rins on the box, on the factory Suzuki.
Alex, you must be so happy with the podium. We saw you lose touch a little at the end. Can you explain what happened?
Yeah, I don't have words to describe this podium. I'm very happy, thanks to the team. They did really good job also in Japan in the winter. And nothing more. Before the start, I was so nervous for all the start delay and everything. And just in the last lap, I run off a little bit on T7, and I was thinking that Miller maybe was on the back. And I pushed to the limit and finally third, so I'm very, very happy.
Congratulations.
Yeah, congratulations to Alex Rins, just 2.5 seconds away from his first Grand Prix victory. Great to see Suzuki back up there after a pretty difficult year for the Hamamatsu factory last season. Alex Rins, of course, had a tough rookie year, spent so much of it injured, but now fully fit, a bit more experience, and his first MotoGP podium. And definitely not his last. Joan Zarco, though, a brilliant second place, a stunning last lap, but not quite good enough to deny Cal Crutchlow. He's down with Simon.
Joan, you don't get much closer to a win than that. Great effort. Can you talk us through the last laps?
The win will come soon. Just need to keep pushing in this way. All the race was pretty difficult. As I say, on the drive Friday, I struggle, and now I was maybe a bit better. We try something, but not relaxed enough to be faster than the other. So behind them all the time, doing my best and try to stay focused to don't do mistake. And at the end, I was thinking that's the time. Try to find a place to pass Crutchlow, but I could not. And second place is pretty good. In the way I was pushing, so it's perfect. happy for him. He was strong already on Friday, so he win the race. And me, I take the points, and I hope really that it's going to come soon.
Thank you, Johan.
It will come soon. It definitely will come soon. He did everything he possibly could. A brilliant last lap, but Cal Crutchlow survived the pressure. He took the fight, didn't he, to the field, just as he did in Qatar, just as he did in Valencia. Six successive front row starts for Johan Zarco. He's led the last three Grand Prix as well at some stage. His time will definitely come. France will very soon have a Premier Class winner to back up Regis Laconi's last win for France in 1999. But today, well, all the headlines are going to be dominated by Cal Crutchlow and the tangles between Marquez and Valentino Rossi. We'll surely hear from your race winner, Cal Crutchlow. What a race. What a race. Here he comes then, Cal Crutchlow. His third win in MotoGP. Stunning performance by the British rider, and he's talking to Simon.
Cal, another MotoGP win. Those last laps, trying to manage it with Johan on your tail, please talk us through it.
It was nice to win. There's no doubt about that, but it was to be expected, to be honest. I came into the weekend thinking I could leave here with a chance of being first or second with Mark, and we ended up winning. I was comfortable in the battle. I felt I took no risks. I stayed with riders that I probably should have and would have been able to drop if I needed to. But I didn't want to take any risks. I stayed out of the slipstream. The front tire was melted. You know, it was too soft a front tire for me. We knew that from the start of the race, but it was drizzling, etc. But we have to be pleased. The team has done a fantastic job in the last two races, and I think we could have fought no matter which circuit it would have been this weekend. Now we go to Austin, and we'll aim for the top five. We have to aim for the top five to come out of there with strong points. But this year I said I wanted to win some races. That was not a tricky race, to be honest, because there was only this wet patch in the last corner, really. And the lap times were as competitive as last year. My fastest lap on the last lap today was the same as my last lap last year. We did a good job today, and I'm pleased. What a fantastic race by Johan and also Alex and Jack. But I knew I needed to get to the front in the last laps because I just knew once I got to the front tire would be perfect.
Congratulations, Cal.
What a day for that man on your screens right now, Cal Crutchlow. Winner here in Argentina. Of course, it's now history. 750 Grand Prix wins for Honda. Right on cue, Tom Phillis, Montjuic in Barcelona, the first of those 750 victories. And as ever, we're indebted to our great friend, Martin Rains, former official MotoGP statistician, who's just put on social media, which is, of course, now being lit up by that incredible Grand Prix. The last British rider to lead the Premier Class Championship. I'm delighted to say that myself and Steve Day, bang on the money, Barry Sheen, 1979. What a day for Cal Crutchlow. Cal Crutchlow said it was stressful. Stressful enough in the commentary box. Don't know what it was like on the motorcycle. That was unforgettable. Unforgettable. Jack Miller talking to his manager, Aki Ayo. He looks frustrated, and why wouldn't he be? Pole position, and he took the fight to the field for such a long time. It's always so, so gutting to miss out on the podium. Just run out of grip, didn't he, at the end there? But that crucial mistake going into turn seven was what did for Miller's podium chances.
Championship standings there. Look, Cal Crutchlow leading ahead of Andrea Dovizioso, who we should just point out has had a much better day at the office than was expected.
We said he's played his get-out-of-jail-free card today. I would not want to be writing a race report for that. You need about 25,000 words, and that's just to get through the first two laps. That was breathtaking, absolutely incredible. Mark Marquez, I mean, some people may argue that having already had two penalties, that the punt into Valentino Rossi, maybe a 30-second penalty wasn't severe enough. But let's not dwell too much on that. Let's look at the positives, because Cal Crutchlow, Honda always looked favourites from the get-go here in Argentina, but most of the smart money was going on a certain Mark Marquez. But when his race unravelled on the grid, Cal Crutchlow brilliantly picked up the baton. What a job for him.
There is so much to discuss here, far beyond even the top three and the brilliant rides from Crutchlow, Zarco, Rins, Miller. But what's just happened there,
at the start of the race, with the delay, with the pole position, with there being three or four rows, split advantage for Miller as they all started from the back of the grid, in inverted commas. Then with all the Marquez drama, goodness me.
This is some hard-earned silverware about to be handed over to those top three riders. Definitely earned their money today. I think I'm right thinking as well. Cal Crutchlow, every single one of his three Grand Prix victories has come when his wife Lucy hasn't been here. I might have to remind him of that after the race. Of course, Lucy normally a constant travel companion for Cal Crutchlow at home watching back in the UK with daughter Willow. I bet they've been screaming at the TV screens back at home. Lucio Cecinello. Well, I remember speaking to Lucio in Thailand at the Buriram test, and he said our target is to win a couple of races this year. It's taken them just a couple of races to do that. Delighted Alex Rins comes to third place on the podium. Johan Zarco, great job by him. He could not have done anything more to beat Cal Crutchlow, but here he is, your new MotoGP World Championship leader, Cal Crutchlow, coming to the top step of the podium here in Argentina. He's been on that podium two times before. Finally, he gets to stand smack bang in the middle of it after a truly dramatic victory here in Argentina. A deep intake of breath you hear in the background. There was Steve Day, who's desperately trying to catch his breath, and why wouldn't he? You run out of superlatives to describe this sport, don't you? LCR Honda then receiving the team trophy. Alex Rins then gets his first ever MotoGP trophy on the factory Suzuki, the 22-year-old from Barcelona. The 41st podium of his Grand Prix career for Rins. Second place will go to the flying Frenchman, Johan Zarco, the 27-year-old. His 45th career podium, his fourth in the MotoGP World Championship. But a British rider has not led a MotoGP World Championship since Barry Sheen way, way back in 1979. We can forget that stat now because Cal Crutchlow has done the business here in Qatar. The 32-year-old British rider, his 125th Grand Prix, his 14th podium, his third win, and the 750th in the history of Honda. And none more have been worked harder for than that one. Crutchlow, your victor here in Argentina.
Cal Crutchlow wins in Argentina in a race that will be talked about for so long, and not just because of the great race that these three put on. We're going to be seeing plenty more of this. MotoGP in round one and two, Matt Burt, have delivered.
Yeah, we built it up. We built it up as potentially being the greatest ever MotoGP World Championship. And after two races, it's been absolutely sensational. It's lived up to the hype and more.